Okay, so with this video, I'm gonna start with burnt umber, burnt sienna, and white. And I'm just gonna put music for the rest of the video because you can see what I'm doing easily. So this is where I'm gonna be putting the highlights. I put an initial color. This is burnt umber, burnt sienna, and white. And I'm just gonna highlight the arms and the legs and paint the face. The arms are done with mitten, and then I'm gonna add some for the hair. I'm gonna paint the hair. So I'm mixing burnt umber, burnt sienna right now with a bit of white, and I'm gonna put the darks, so underneath the nose, underneath the lip, and then I'll start highlighting where my highlights are. So the whole thing is going to be light and dark, just different values. And that's it. Next week we won't have a class, we'll have a class after. You can see now I'm putting some underneath the lip, lower lip. Anyway, no class next week. All right. Enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, in here I'm putting right now yellow ochre with a bit of white after I initially put burnt umber and yellow ochre. And now I'm going to start highlighting slowly. So the yellow ochre is highlighted, the hair is highlighted slowly. So with a brown brush, just put some highlights and we're going to go slowly on that because it's a... You don't want the hair to look too white. right away. So let's put some yellow ochre white and strands of hair. And then I will add the highlight slowly to make it look like it is shiny from the light. So there's a band of hair right there that where the light hits, and it's going to be the shiniest part. So usually I'm very careful with my highlights, because once you add white to any highlight, to any color, it will make it flat. So that's the best way of highlighting the hair, using white and yellow ochre and increasing the amount of white slowly. Here you can see I'm darkening the hair a bit on the top part. Otherwise the head will look flat. So I have to have a darker color. So I'm using burnt umber and yellow ochre and just putting a bit of a darker part of the hair on top. And then I'm increasing now the amount of burnt umber because I couldn't see it. So now it's just making sure that the top part is darker. So this is the difference, is dark, medium, light. That's my values. It's dark on top, medium in between the strong highlight and the dark. So I'm gonna start highlighting the putting slowly a strong highlight where the shiny part is. And I usually try to make it smaller, where the more I add white, the smaller, the narrower or the smaller the area is. And now after, you will see I will start putting a little bit of kind of a in-between color between the yellow ochre and the top part of the head, because you have dark, medium and light. You don't want that strong jump between the light and the medium and the dark. It has to be a very soft transition from dark to light. That's done. All right, this is done. So usually what I do is I try to adjust all of my highlights and my values once the color is dry. You can see right now it's like a band of the highlight, so I go back and I adjust it, add more highlights, maybe stronger shinier look in there. It's really flat right now, but it can be adjusted easily.